Well, my father, you see, as you know, he was an astronomer, and he's also sort of a philosopher in a way. He had a rather occult view of the world, but he had these strong ideas that he wanted to live with, dominating his life, and then he wanted to persuade everybody around him that he was Plato and Aristotle bound up in one, you see, with the ultimate truth in his head. And he couldn't stop talking about the ideas that were in his mind. That was fine, except he just couldn't stop. He couldn't be questioned. And if you did sort of try to get him to rephrase it or question it or modify it, he'd get really quite annoyed. He just had to have all this pouring out all the time. And he used to bore pants off people. And I decided I just wouldn't do that because I tend to get dominated by ideas as well, like you do, like any intelligent person does. So I interspersed the great philosophical musings that were going on in my mind were jokes, you see, to leaven them, to break the thing up a bit. So it had two results of this. One was that I felt I wasn't going to bore people, which of course is completely fallacious because it spoilt the flow of the discussion and ruined it. And secondly, I felt that it broke up one's brain circuit. So instead of going around in circles or repeating what one has said for years and years, it forced one to sort of think again, to change one's mind. And also, the third thing, I suppose, is that it brought the other people into the act. And even if they didn't know about inductive reasoning or the nature of gravity or some such thing, they could at least share a joke. So it had a social impact. But largely, I think a whole load of jokes are detrimental, actually.